On the 13th of September, we venerate St. John Chrysostom, who was an important early church father who served as Archbishop of Constantinople. He was perhaps the greatest preacher in the history of the church and the most prominent Greek father of the church. Eloquent and uncompromising preaching was typical of John and earned him the name history would remember him by, Chrysostomus, meaning golden mouth. But his preaching, though considered the best in the early church, was what got him into trouble and led to his untimely death. Born in Antioch in the year 347, John also grew up in Antioch, received an excellent classical Greek education, and upon meeting the holy bishop Meletius, he decided to devote his time to the study of religious works and the sacred scriptures. He received baptism after 3 years of study and set out for the desert to live the ascetic life of a hermit. His extreme mortifications left him in fragile health, and he thus returned to Antioch after 2 years of recovery and devoted himself to studying for the priesthood. He quickly went from lector to deacon to priest at the church in Antioch. He was ordained in 386 and served in the Cathedral of Antioch for 12 years, winning widespread fame for his sublime preaching. In the year 398, he was seized by soldiers and forcefully appointed Archbishop of Constantinople. His kidnapping was arranged by a government official who wanted to adorn the church in the capital city with the best orator in Christianity. Rather than rebelling against the injustice, John accepted it as God's providence. And rather than soften his words for his new and prestigious audience, which now included many from the imperial household, John continued themes he preached in Antioch. He railed against abuses of wealth and power. Even his lifestyle itself was a scandal. He lived an ascetic life, used his considerable household budget to care for the poor and build hospitals. He continued preaching against the great public sins. His lack of tact and political skill made him too many enemies in the imperial family, mainly the Empress Eudoxia, and also among fellow bishops. Theophilus, the Archbishop of Alexandria, was able to call a council outside of Constantinople, and trumping up false charges of heresy, had John deposed from office. John was exiled to Armenia, to an isolated place along the Black Sea, by Empress Eudoxia and Emperor Arcadius. John was transported across the plains of Asia Minor in the heat of summer, and almost immediately his health began to fail him. He died during the journey in 407 in Pontus, his ill health unable to endure its rigors. 34 years later, after John's chief enemies had died, his relics were brought back in triumph to the capital. Emperor Theodosius II, son of Arcadius and Eudoxia, publicly asked forgiveness for the sins of his parents. St. John Chrysostom's many writings, especially homilies and commentaries on the Gospels, still exist and have exerted great influence over the centuries. He was later given the caption of Doctor of the Church because of the value of his surviving writings, which totals 600 sermons and 200 letters. Along with Basil the Great, St. Gregory and St. Athanasius, he is considered one of the greatest of the early church fathers. Placing all our petitions before him today, let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, who willed that the Bishop St. John Chrysostom should be illustrious by his wonderful eloquence and his experience of suffering, grant us, we pray, that instructed by his teachings, we may be strengthened through the example of his invincible patience. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen.